Hi, Kirby Woods, Pastor Calvin. With today's devotion, we find ourselves in Mark chapter 3. And the Bible's talking about Jesus, and it says, and he went up on the mountain, and he called to him those he himself wanted, and they came to him. And he appointed 12 that they might be with him, and that he might send them out to preach and to have power to heal sickness and to cast out demons. Simon, whom he gave the name Peter, James, the son of Zebedee, and John, the brother of James, to whom he gave the name Boanerges, which is sons of thunder, Andrew, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, the son of Alphaeus, Thaddeus, Simon the Canaanite, and Judas Iscariot, who also betrayed him. You know, there's a couple of things that kind of jump out at me at this verse. One of the things is that Jesus had a purpose. He called each of these people by name. He called them because he had a reason to call them. He had a job for them to do. He had a purpose for them. You know, I was looking in the scripture recently about purpose. If you walk in Ephesians chapter 1, the Bible says that he's called us according to his purpose, according to his good purpose. He's gifted us according to his purpose. He's done this. According to his purpose, he's done that. Romans 8, 28, all things work together for good to those who love the Lord, to those who are called according to his purpose. What I want you to understand this morning is that even as God in the flesh, Jesus called these disciples to himself and had a purpose for them, so he has called you and he has a purpose for you. You may not be an apostle, but you are certainly a disciple. You are a follower of Jesus Christ, and he's called you to preach the gospel, to shed the light of the gospel in a very dark world. And the other thing that I find very interesting here is he gave some of them a name. He gave Peter, Simon, the name Peter, which is Petra, which is rock. And then he gave James and John, he gave them the name of Sons of Thunder. What an appellation that is, Sons of Thunder. I wonder sometimes what he might call us. Are we sons of timidity or daughters of weakness? Or are we men and women of strength? What kind of name would he give us? I think a lot of that has to do with our trust in him and our willingness to be obedient to what he's called us to do. God has a purpose for you today. I don't want you to forget that. He has not called you by accident or by mistake or without a specific reason. He has a purpose for your life. He has a plan to use you to bring glory to himself. He has a plan to bring others to faith in Jesus Christ through your testimony and through your witness. And he has, the Bible says, written our names in the Lamb's Book of Life from before the foundation of the earth. And someday, when we get to heaven, we're going to have a new name. That's going to be a wonderful, wonderful day. I love you. I hope you'll be with us this coming Lord's Day as we continue our study in 1 Samuel. God bless. We'll see you Sunday.